Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to solve staircase HackerRank problem. So in this problem we have to print a staircase like this if n equals to 4. So as an input we will be receiving an integer n denoting the size of the staircase. In our output format we have to print like this. If n equals to 4 we have to print like this. If n equals to 6 we have to print like this. Let's first understand this. How it's basically this is the input, you will be getting 6, and you have to print a pattern like this. So guys, for suppose 6 is not here, I'm putting 6 somewhere here. Yep, 6. So here we have how many rows? 6 rows. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 rows. And we have a 6 column also. Let me show you how. See, this is the first column. This is the second column. This is the third column. And so on. We have a fourth, fifth, sixth column. So we have to print a matrix basically. So 6 by 6. This one, this matrix. So here if nothing is there, there is actually space. So if it is a 6, so we are printing 6 minus 0 number, 5 spaces, and then 1 followed by hash symbol. For the second row we are printing 6 minus 2 spaces, then followed by hash symbol. For 3, we are printing 6 minus 3 symbols, followed by hash symbols. Sorry, this is a space and then hash symbol. For 4th row, we are printing 6 minus 4, 2 spaces, followed by 4 hash symbols. See how many rows are there? That much symbol we have to print. N minus that symbol, that will be the space count. Hope guides clear to you. So the same we have to apply in our code. Definitely we are printing rows and columns, so they will be nested for loop. Let's start. Yeah, so this is the function we have received n as an input, which will tell you the number of staircases, and you have to print pattern like this up to n. So definitely there will be two for loop printing rows and columns. So this is the one loop which will take care of the rows. How many rows we have to print? We have to print the rows from 1 to n. Inside that we will be having a node which will print the element. Oh sorry, it's bj. Why we are using n minus I? Let me tell you. So here if you can see, this is a 6 and row is a first, then we are printing 6 minus 1, 5 spaces. For second, n is equal to 6 and we have second row, so we are printing 4 spaces. So in general case, we have n as an input instead of 6 minus in every row, it's a, we are decrementing, so it's b minus I. If n values, I value is 0 and I value is 1, then we are printing 5 spaces. If I value is 2, we are printing 4 spaces. So here we will print the space. One more thing guys, we don't need to use println because otherwise it will print the space in the next line, which we don't want, so we'll remove it. So after printing the spaces, we have to print the hash symbol. So we'll take one for loop, which will print the hash symbol, this for loop will run through one, it will print one. It's two, it will print 1 to 2. Means if it's the first row, it will print first only one time hexadecimal. If it's the second row, it will print two hexadecimal. If it's the third row, it will print third hexadecimal. So printing the hexadecimal. Here also we have to use only print because we have to print this same line. And once you printed one line, you have to go to the next line. So here we can, this print line is enough to go to the next line. Because once you print the complete line, you have to go to the next line. Let's run this program. So here you can see the test has got passed. Let's submit the solution. Yeah, so this is accepted by HackerRank. So guys, I have one more way to solve this. Let me show you how we can solve another way. Solve this. Done. So I can take one string such as, and only one loop you can solve this problem. You'll be amazing like how this problem can be solved in loop. Press 2. So again guys, I'll explain whatever I'm doing. Yeah, first let's run this. I hope it should work. Let's try to submit this code. Yeah, so guys, let me tell you the idea behind this. I have taken a temporary string, which is a hash, because every line we have to print hash. And we have to print the hash to the number of order of values given for n. So we have taken value from 0 to less than n, less than n. And here I am utilizing this printf function, which is used for formatting. And you can see this program, we have to format our output basically in a proper form. So I'm utilizing this printf function to format our my output. So what this is does, let me tell you, this is for just printing, and here what means every line it has to print this much character. N is 6, so it has to print 6 character basically. S stands for string because we are printing string over here, so the string length will be 6. And slash n is for new line. So every time if your string length is less than 6, it will automatically append space before that. So what is happening over here, and in starting, str is hash, only one hash is there. So, but this is 6. So it has to print 6 length string, which is 6. But here the length is 1. So it will automatically append 5 spaces before that, and it will print. For the next line, when string got updated with hash plus hash, so in this time we have string length of 2. And then it has to print length of string 6. So it, what it will do, it will append 4 spaces before that and print the string. So like that, it will print the whole string. I hope guys it makes sense, and it's just like another way how you can do it. That's all guys from my side. Thanks for watching.